Hi, I am Palab. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. In this video, we are going to talk about an important and relatively recent innovation in economic analysis called behavioral economics. Traditional economic theory is based on the assumption that decision makers are self-interested, have stable preferences, unaffected by context, are good at drawing implications from the available information, and that they possess plenty of willpower to carry out their decisions. But these assumptions describe a robot better than a human being. By merging insights from economics and psychology, behavioral economists show that people deviate from the rational decision maker depicted by neoclassical economists in consistent and predictable ways. Let's look at some examples. Many experiments found that losing $10 burns more than the happiness of gaining $10. This phenomena is called loss aversion. The tendency of losses to be more salient to a decision maker than acquiring equivalent gains. The result is that people's decisions are influenced by the fear of losing more than the thrill of winning in a way that discourages new enterprise less than optimally. In experiments, students were given a sum of money, say $10, and were asked how much they wanted to share with a stranger. Neoclassical economics would predict that they behave selfishly and share nothing. Yet the experiments consistently found that students were likely to keep around 60% of the total sum. This suggests that fairness, the idea that resources should be allocated evenly, might play a part in students' decision-making process, a feature overlooked by traditional economic models. Choosing might also be burdensome for people. This often leads to the status quo bias. The tendency of taking the status quo as a reference point and not deviating from it. For instance, organ donors increase drastically when people are requested to waive their registration as a donor, instead of actively enrolling, suggesting that people tend to stick with the choice that is assigned to them rather than question it. Very often, we do not have all the information necessary to make a decision. We draw inferences from what we know using heuristics, mental shortcuts or rules of thumb. Heuristics can lead to mistakes that are consistent and predictable. For instance, on any given subject, people tend to evaluate any new information based on the first piece of information they receive, even when the order is random. This process, called anchoring, implies that people adjust their opinions too little when new evidence is presented. Availability bias is another wrinkle in behavioral economics. This refers to tendency of people to believe that events are more common than they are simply because they are easier to recall. People often overestimate the risk of shark attacks compared to, say, car accidents, because the former is much more memorable. Finally, even when people make rational decisions, they might not be able to stick to them. How many people try to stop smoking but never succeed? This is why commitment devices, like friends monitoring one's progress, are important. These are only some of the ways people might deviate from the rational decision maker explored by behavioral economists. For more videos on this and other topics, or to speak with a subject matter expert, visit us at Chegg. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.